Hello everyone, my name is Guide Anamika Sharma. I'm a part of Bharat Scouts and Guides, Chandigarh. So today I will be telling you about the lashings, square lashing and figure eight lashing. So let us start with the figure eight lashing. So what is the figure eight lashing? This lashing is basically used to tie three poles, the parallel poles together to make a tripod. It is also known as the round or tripod lashing. So this tripods are the base of many engineering projects, which make this one of the most important lashings you need to know. It is a part of many scouting projects. So this figure of eight lashing is also known as round or tripod lashing. It is used to bring together three spars to form a tripod origin. Now let's watch a video to see how we make it. So as you can see, the base of it is three wooden sticks and it is being tied together in the form of a tripod. And we always start this with a clove hitch on the first rope. One more thing, you also have to make sure not to tie it too tight at the starting like the person is doing. He is leaving some space between all of the sticks so that the sticks don't just stick together and they can also form a tripod. Now, in order for this to stand, the person is tying two long knots on the areas between the poles. And now, to finish it all off, the person is tying a clove hitch on the opposite pole. So what is square lashing? Square lashing is basically used to bind two poles together at a 90 degree angle. Square lashing knots can also be used to make a rectangular frame. This lashing is designed to load bearing and can be used to create scaffolding. Although the two poles usually cross each other at 90 degrees, the square lashing may be used when the angle between the two poles is as little as 45 degrees. Now, let's see a video to see how this knot is. So, the first step in a square lashing is to put two of the poles at a 90 degree angle to each other. Now, the person is tying a clove knit, a clove hitch to the first area. You have to make sure that the clove hitch is very tight, as that is the base to this entire knot. And also, the length of the rope that is there, you have to rope it around the other rope so that it doesn't get in between. Now, you will take this rope and you will put it across and wrap it, as you can see it is shown in the video. So you take the rope back and then you pull it from the top and then you bring it in the front again. Another thing, you have to make sure to tie the knots as closely as possible, as this knot can open very quickly and it will not hold structures together if it is very loose. Now, we do this very tightly till the rope is about to end. Tie a knot at one of the sides of the rope, whichever end it is coming to, and you tie it as tightly as possible. Then you, as shown in the video, you take the rope and you snitch it backwards and forwards. And then you tie another knot. This one, you do the same thing. And then you tie another knot and you tie it as tightly as possible. This is somewhat your final knot should look like.